Semiconductor technology now makes it possible to implement a supercomputer on a chip in an affordable way. This video introduces ALPACA, a system on chip for accelerating nested loop programs from many different application areas, including digital signal and image processing and neural networks for machine learning. ALPACA's design is rooted in the concept of tightly coupled processor arrays, or TCPA for short, a class of massively parallel microprocessor arrays, as elaborated in the following. A TCPA consists of many tiny processor cores called processing elements, or PEs for short, arranged in a two-dimensional array. It exploits multiple levels of parallelism, including word level, instruction level, and finally loop level parallelism with reconfigurable interconnections and pipeline data flow through the processor array. At the periphery of the TCPA, a configuration manager loads instruction sequences into the PEs, central global controllers manage the entire control flow of these PEs, and address generators are used to move the data from the peripheral I/O buffers to the PEs and back. Let's explore how machine learning applications such as convolutional neural networks can be parallelized and mapped onto a TCPA. A CNN consists of multiple layers of neurons called convolutional layers, pooling layers, and activation layers. Shown here is a convolutional layer, which is representative of other types of layers. An input image, shown in the middle, is convolved with a local operator, the filter shown on the left. By moving the filter over the input image, an output image is created pixel by pixel. Finally, not just one, but several filters are applied to produce a set of output images, also called feature maps. Now, let's see how these layers of operations can be efficiently mapped onto a processor array. Basically, regions of convolutions are assigned to individual PEs. This is done by segmenting the input image into tiles of equal size. These tiles are streamed through the rows of the PEs, while the filter coefficients are streamed through the columns of the array. How does it work? The programming of a TCPA starts with a given for loop. In our example, a 2D loop nest with iteration variables i0 and i1 for the vector matrix multiplication of a vector B by a matrix A. Then, a partitioning of the loop is done. The next step is to partition the loop iteration space of size n by m in such a way that each PE processes the iterations of one tile. A problem here is that the loop bounds n and m are usually not known at compile time. However, our compiler is able to partition loop programs with parameterized loop bounds using a concept called symbolic loop mapping. The process of creating instruction sequences for the PEs and scheduling the entire loop nest is called instantiation, which happens at runtime. Here, each tile, shown in green, is assigned to a PE for execution one at a time. Now, let's delve into the ALPACA chip specification and design. The ALPACA chip has been implemented in a 22-nanometer FDSOI technology and occupies a chip area of 10 square millimeters. This corresponds to approximately 6 million standard cells and almost 100 million transistors. Clocking at 700 MHz, the core integrates 64 PEs with 192 vector floating point units, each of which can simultaneously perform either 132-bit single precision or 4 8-bit floating point computations in parallel, achieving a performance of around 537 billion floating point operations per second. On the periphery, you can see one I/O buffer per side, each consisting of 32 memory banks and 16 address generators. You can also see the loop I/O controller, which fetches data to and from the array in a timely manner by issuing DMA requests. To test a supercomputer on a chip, we designed a test board containing an ALPACA chip, a power supply, a parallel data interface, an FPGA mezzanine card connector through which the chip receives its clock signals and data from the DRAM, and a JTAG interface for debugging the chip. Now, let's see the ALPACA chip in action. The test board is mounted on a commercial FPGA board. In this setup, the supply voltage is provided by the shown external power supply, which measures the power consumption of the chip. On the FPGA, an embedded microprocessor is used to load compiled configuration data into the ALPACA chip, which executes the compiled loop nest afterwards. The loop I/O controller schedules the transfer of result data from the I/O buffers over the FMC interface back to the FPGA board. Next, we demonstrate an edge detection video filter on the ALPACA chip. Images are sampled from a USB webcam connected to the FPGA and transferred to the TCPA for processing. The resulting output image is visualized on the left. For a deeper dive into the architecture and compilation aspects of ALPACA, the interested reader is referred to the following list of publications on architecture and compilation aspects of ALPACA. Concepts of TCPAs and related compilation methodologies have been investigated within the Research Center Invasive Computing. Thank you.